In this video series about how to teach remotely, I'm going to be showcasing some of the best technology programs you can use to teach your students from a distance. All the programs I'm going to be showing in this series are completely free. A lot of EdTech companies out there that normally cost money have also made their programs available for teachers to use for the rest of this school year free of charge. My goal with this series is to show you how you can continue to plan engaging and rigorous lessons for your students, even when you're not in the classroom with them. In this video, I'm going to teach you how you can teach a super engaging lesson using a program called Flipgrid. Flipgrid is an incredibly dynamic platform where students can access content and then respond to prompts by creating short videos. Once a student creates a video, the rest of the class is able to view and respond to that video. I love bulletin board programs like Flipgrid for remote learning because it still allows students and teachers to interact together and can combat some of that feeling of loneliness that might come from distance learning. My name is Sam Kary, and this is my YouTube channel for the new EdTech classroom. If you find the tips that I share in this video helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss any of my video updates. I've been using Flipgrid with my students for quite some time, but it's also a tool that is almost perfect for remote learning. One of the many great things about Flipgrid is that students can access it from a computer, a tablet, or a mobile device. So let's jump in and see what Flipgrid is all about. Teachers can sign up for a Flipgrid account for free. Go to the Educator Sign Up button. Then you can sign up with either a Google account or a Microsoft account. I'll fill out some basic information about myself to create my account. And to get started, I'm going to click Start My Grid. A grid is essentially like a classroom. So here I'm going to name the grid the name of my class. Next, you're going to select a grid type. Selecting a grid type is going to control the privacy setting of your account. If you select school email, that will only allow people who enter into your grid with either a Microsoft or a Google school email account to be able to join your grid. I always choose school email. Notice below that there is a flip code. You can customize the back end of that URL if you want. Once you're ready, click next. Here you'll add your school email domains to control who has access to your grid. Now that the grid is ready, you'll see you have lots of options for how you could share the link with students. I usually skip this step because I haven't actually created any assignments. I'm going to show you how to share the assignments with students in a little bit. Okay, now we're on the My Grids page. You want to think of a grid like an individual class that you can add assignments to. If I want to add new classes, I can click on Add New Grid and then go through the same process that I just went through to add individual grids, which I'm going to treat as separate classes that I teach. Notice the drop-down action menu on the grid. A useful function here is that if you have a co-teacher that you want to add, you can click Add Copilot, enter your co-teacher's name, click the Invite button, and that's going to send that teacher an email inviting them to be a co-teacher on your account. Note that the person you invite will need to already have a Flipgrid account set up in order for this to work. Before I show you how to create an assignment, let's first look at what an assignment in Flipgrid would actually look like. So for this assignment, students read a book and then recorded a video review of that book. This would potentially be a great thing to do for remote learning. You can see the assignment title and the GIF and instructions at the top. And in a second, I'm going to show you how to customize all of that. When I scroll down on the page, I'm able to see all the individual videos that my students have posted, as well as the replies that other students posted to each other. When I click on an individual student, I'm able to view the specific video that they posted for this assignment. You'll see there's a place where I am able to provide my own video feedback to students. If I choose not to record a video response, I can also just add written feedback. Here at the bottom, you'll see that I also have the opportunity as the teacher to reply to this student. And if I choose this option, that's going to be posted for the rest of the class to see. And you can see here that another student already replied to this student with her own video feedback about that other student's topic. What I really love about this for remote learning is that it's going to give students the option to still continue to interact with each other in meaningful ways. All right, now I'm going to show you what it would look like when a student logs into Flipgrid. When they scroll down, they're going to be able to see the video responses that all of their classmates have posted. When they're ready to post their own video, they'll click on the green plus button, and they can also view and respond to each of their classmates' videos in the grid. Now that you've seen what an individual assignment looks like, I want to show you where you can go in Flipgrid to access a ton of pre-created assignments that you can take and use as is or edit however you'd like. If you go up to the Disco Library tab, you'll see that in the library are an enormous amount of assignments that have already been created by teachers or by other education technology companies that have integrations with Flipgrid. So for example, if you scroll down to the featured Disco playlist and you click on the Flocabulary playlist, you'll see that Flocabulary has pre-created a bunch of different Flipgrid lessons that you could select and add directly to your grid. You'll see that you can also fully customize that assignment. We're gonna take a look at how to do that in just a moment. And the pre-created assignments already come with a resource that you can use in order to introduce a topic or lesson to your students. In addition to the pre-created playlist, you'll see that there is also a place where you can search for topics that you are looking for. So let's just say, for example, that I'm interested in teaching my students about planets. I can search for lessons about planets, and there I see that nearly 900 lessons have already been made in Flipgrid. I like to look at the engagement time as well as the number of times an assignment has been used in order to gauge what assignment I might want to use with my students. Like the other assignment we just looked at, this assignment also comes with a resource for students, and you can add it to your grid with the single click of a button. Notice once I've added new topics from the Disco library, they show up in my grid and are ready for me to use with students. All right, let's go ahead and jump into one of these assignments so you can see how it works. In order to edit the assignment, you're going to want to go to Actions and select Edit Topic. Here you'll see that I'm able to change the title of the topic. You can change the duration of the recording time. The video response that students create can be as short as 15 seconds or as long as 5 minutes. Next, you'll see that you're able to edit the instructions however you'd like. If you click Delete Focus, it's now going to allow you to fully customize how you want to introduce the assignment. There are really loads of different options here. I particularly like recording my own video for students the first time that I'm going to ask them to do a Flipgrid assignment, in part just to model what I'm looking for and also break the ice a little bit and showing students that I'm willing to take the same risk that I'm asking them to take by recording a video first. So to record a video, you're going to click on Record Video. This video creation studio looks exactly the way that the student creation studio would look. So I'm going to walk through all the different features that are available when recording a video. First, you'll see up at the top that you can add a sticky note. Adding a sticky note would allow you to actually add some text directly to the video. Then at the bottom, you'll see that there are different customization options. The first is to filter the video for color. So let's take a look at what some of those color filters would look like. You'll notice the pixelated feature. So this is actually a great one for students if they're feeling uncomfortable with showing their face in the video. They can pixelate their face and still continue to participate. All right, I like this super cool one. So let's go with that. Next, if you wanted to add text in another way other than a sticky note, you could also just write directly onto the video by clicking on the text icon, select a color that you like, type what you want to write, and you can also select that text box and drag it wherever you want it to go. There are stickers that you can add to your video. This sticker can also be expanded as big as you want it. And this is another way that students could potentially hide their face if they weren't super excited about having their face in a video. There's also a drawing function, so you and your students could draw directly onto the video. Next is a board option. You can choose the board option to treat this essentially like a whiteboard or a blackboard, where you might just want to add some different text or instructions. Lastly, there's a custom sticker choice. Here, since I use Bitmoji and my students are really familiar with the fact that I do that and I want to keep some of that familiarity, I might select a Bitmoji, drop it in, scale it down, and there you see that I have a fully customized screen. Now that I'm ready to record my video, I'm going to strive to provide my students with a very brief explanation about what the assignment is going to be about. And I'm going to model for them my own answer to the question about how I'm personally feeling about remote learning. So once I'm ready to record, I'm going to hit record. Oops, oh no, I realize I'm not ready. Okay, so here, I don't want this video in. I'm going to click that redo button. This happens with students all the time. If they want to redo, click on redo, confirm. All right, now I'm going to try again. Once I'm done with that video, I'm going to click next. And here I can re-watch the video that I just recorded. If I realize that there were some places in the video that I wanted to clip, I could just slide that bar. And wherever I slide the video is going to be the section of the video that is actually posted to Flipgrid. Once I'm ready, I'm going to click confirm. If I realize I want to add more video, I could always click add more. And for this last part, you and your students are going to snap a quick selfie. That selfie is going to become the thumbnail that is going to show up in this particular assignment. Once you're ready, click on the camera. And just like the video, the selfie is also fully customizable with filters, text, stickers, drawings, etc. Once you're ready, click next. And now you'll see that the thumbnail showed up as the focus for the media resource that I'm going to use to engage students. When you scroll down, you'll see there's a section where you can add a topic tip. So here I might direct my students, for example, to practice a few times before actually recording their video. You could add additional attachments to the assignment. So here's where it would be relevant to add some supplementary material. It could be an article or a video that you want your students to read or watch. And when you scroll down, you'll see that you're able to fully customize the setting. The first setting is for video moderation. So if you're concerned that students might be posting videos that are not appropriate, or if you just want to make sure that you're checking the videos before they actually get posted to the grid, then you would want to turn on video moderation. You can turn on or off student-to-student replies. I typically keep this on so that my students are able to respond to each other via video. You can also change the status of the topic. If it's active, students will be able to access it right away. Frozen would be view only so that students could view the videos but would not be able to post new responses. Hidden would be appropriate if you're wanting to create an assignment but still work on editing it and it's not quite ready to be posted. Flipgrid has a built-in feedback system. The basic feedback is just giving them feedback on their ideas and also their performance in the video. If you wanted to create your own custom feedback rubric, you could do that by clicking on custom feedback, add criteria, and there you could build your own customized rubric for how you would be grading their responses. All right, once you're ready to launch the assignment, you're gonna click update topic. And now let's see how it would look on the student end. First, you're going to need to share this assignment with students. And there are several different ways you can do that. If you're looking to share it on Google Classroom, hit the share button, share to Google Classroom, then select the class that you want to share the assignment to. You'll be brought to Google Classroom where you can set up the assignment and assign it to students. And then students will be able to log into their Google Classrooms, select the assignment, log in with their email, and you'll see that the student was brought directly to the assignment page where they can watch the video introduction to the assignment that I just created. When they're ready to add their own response, they'll click on the green plus button. Another good option would be to copy the link to the assignment and then embed it in a Google Slides hyperdoc. If you haven't watched my other video about how to set up a Google Slides hyperdoc for remote learning, I definitely recommend that you check that out. Okay, that should cover the most important information you need to know to set up remote learning experiences with your students using Flipgrid. If you have any questions about how I plan to use Flipgrid for remote learning, please ask in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching my video to the end. If you found the tips that I shared helpful, please hit the like button, share it with other teachers that you know, and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss any of my weekly updates. Thanks so much and have a great week.